Hello. In this video, we'll be looking at how to use BQML to build time series forecasting models in BigQuery. Let's set the stage. Picture this. We have data, perhaps streaming time series data, pouring in continuously from somewhere, perhaps an IoT system or a web application. So what's next? This stream of data has to find its way into BigQuery. Hold on though, sometimes we may need an intermediary like PubSub or Dataflow to help us process the data before it gets loaded into BigQuery. If you're asking yourself what PubSub and Dataflow are, well, PubSub is ideal for streaming data, whereas Dataflow allows for processing via either the batch or streaming paradigms. Imagine for a second, data flows from distributed IoT services or our web application into PubSub. Then, Dataflow helps us clean it, transform it, or aggregate it before loading the data into BigQuery. But here's where the real excitement comes in. Picture our AI systems interacting with the BigQuery dataset, making predictions, creating forecasts, or analyzing anomalies. There are a variety of ways to use BigQuery ML over this time series data in a low-code and simplistic manner. Shall we dive in? Let's load some representative example data directly into BigQuery. Doing this keeps the tutorial crisp, focusing less on the specifics of streaming data itself. Let's start a Git repository for our work today. We'll share all code and diagrams in the video description. We'll just be crafting a simple script to generate some test data. Our data will follow a certain trend instead of being completely random. Consider the case of generating sales data. Using pandas, NumPy, and the datetime module, we'll simulate data over 10 days of business operations. The result will be random but normally distributed data, demonstrating an upward linear trend. This is a hidden treasure that we will uncover during our BigQuery analysis. After creating a pandas data frame and assigning a date for each day, we'll save it all in a CSV file. Let's generate the data, and voila, we've got an overall rising trend interspersed with some noise. Now we need to transport this into BigQuery. A cloud storage bucket can come in handy here. We'll create a bucket, copy our sales data into it, and voila, our data is comfortably sitting in the bucket, ready to be imported into BigQuery. Let's first create a dataset, then generate a table in that dataset from our CSV file. It's super easy to browse cloud storage, and once we pick the file, BigQuery will just get it. Let's call this sales data, mirroring the CSV naming and auto-detect the schema. If there's a header row, let's add that and see if our table turns up beautifully. Ready to dive deeper? Okay, so we've got 10 rows. Let's check the schema again. It looks like our clever system has managed to identify that our date was a timestamp and our sales was a floating number. Now we get to the fun part. Using BigQuery to query this sumptuous data. As a simple start, we're just going to select our data here. Remember, you need to specify your personal project, the dataset, and then finally the table. Let's stretch our perspective a bit, zoom out. Ah, there, you can see the validation of this query. It's promising around 160 bytes of data. Fantastic. There's all our data in its raw glory. Scroll further down to encounter the 10th row. But there's more. Now we aspire to birth a time series model with this data. Here's a hint of the underlying structure of our BigQuery ML. We'll create or replace a model, and we're doing this straight within SQL. No need for heavy-duty machine learning engineering or advanced gymnastics here. We've got our BigQuery time series project, our sample dataset, and we've labeled this our sales forecast model. Let's consult our trusty documentation to decode some of its secrets. We won't trivialize this step since it's brimming with various options, even though we're merely forecasting using ARIMA, a straightforward approach. All right, on the documentation page here, we'll hunt for BQML time series. This mirrors exactly what we've constructed here, our ARIMA Plus model. Oh, look here, we also have this option for multivariate forecasting. We get thorough documentation complemented by useful diagrams. The ARIMA Plus model offers a multitude of options, handling details like holiday effects, figuring out frequency, and accommodating irregular time intervals. All this grunt work would otherwise be done manually if you were to employ a different strategy. Naturally, we have some best practices too, but the standout here are the numerous configuration options at your disposal. See this time series timestamp column? It's just one option you will encounter when creating your model. Each is carefully explained, giving you full visibility. A bit unsure about an option? Just search it up, simple as that. For instance, the decompose option determines whether to separate the historical and forecasted parts of the time series. Now that we've declared the model, we'll require a select statement to scoop up our data. Once again, be sure to provide your project and dataset details here. It seems our data frequency isn't gelling well. Let's take this opportunity to rectify it. Aha! It seems we should have used auto frequency instead of auto detect. That's much better. Now what's really cool is that because this is a BigQuery specific ML feature, everything is just native. We have the SQL experience and then our models show up right here in the standard BigQuery Explorer. If we go to the model, we'll be able to see information about the training options, things like loss, which is not as important for this particular training, but also things like evaluation and the schema. There are lots of cool details about the model. But, of course, the next exciting part is going to be evaluating and using the model, and we can do that all in SQL still. So let's go ahead and run an evaluation where we'll see results. This evaluation gives us a lot of technical details that might be interesting for things like seasonality or spiking. But the real meat here is going to be doing predictions. Let's get the next 10 days, for example, of forecasted data from our model. So we go to the BQML and then set the project, the dataset, and the confidence level. This horizon just means how many more cycles we're going to be looking at together with this forecast. And then we run that. Note that we see this trend increasing, so our forecasted value for the next series is 213. This is actually best understood with the context of our previous data. So let's do precisely that. we see where we ended off. We ended our time series on the 23rd and at a value of about 200. So we're picking up really nicely on the 24th with a value of 213. So this kind of linear type trend, it was able to pick up on. And of course, we see lots of technical metrics for this forecasting. As always, we'll leave the SQL code, the Python code, and the diagram file in the video description. We hope that this video was helpful and want to thank you very much for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.